Hallelujah, praises to the Almighty Lord God in heaven, world's first language. There is always a debate among people, which is the first spoken and written language in the world. So, let's have a glance on this in brief from the Word of God, the Holy Bible. Officially by the World Research, six languages are considered to be the oldest. They are Latin, Greek, Mandarin, Hebrew, Tamil, and Coptic. All these six ancient languages are spoken and is alive today. The Latin language is been used by the Romans, Greek by Greece, Mandarin by Chinese, Hebrew by Jews, Tamil by Dravidians, and Coptic by the Egyptians. When you come to the Word of God, the Bible, you can see there how these languages got into existence. After the flood, Noah's ark rested on the land as said in Genesis chapter 8 verse 4, and the ark rested in the seventh month, on the 17th day of the month, upon the mountains of Ararat. After Noah's period, his three sons and their family were living in a single place. In that hierarchy after certain generation, Nimrod started to build a tower at a place in Babylon which is the present Iraq, as stated in Genesis chapter 11 verse 4, and they said, "Go to, let us build us a city and a tower, whose top may reach unto heaven, and let us make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth." Since all of them were in one place, the whole generation of Noah spoke one language, as they were living as one nation, which you can see it in Genesis chapter 11 verse 1, and the whole earth was of one language, and of one speech. Researchers have found out the time of occurrence to be around 4000 BC. During this period, God has confused their language and were driven out of the place. Later on the other languages started to develop, as written in Genesis chapter 11 verse 9, therefore is the name of it called Babel, because the Lord did there confound the language of all the earth, and from thence did the Lord scatter them abroad upon the face of all the earth. We have already published about the scattering of Noah's generation in the title, Russian Formation, you can go through it. So the entire people who were in the world were at the place Babel, which now at present is Iraq. They had only one language and were as one nation. As God drew them out of that place, they split into different areas. As per the world records, the first language which they have obtained from the previous script is dated around 4000 BC. Bible's first language is also around 4000 BC. Both the comparison are getting perfectly matched. From this, the first and oldest language which was spoken by the olden days people is Tamil. This language still now exists, which is spoken by the Dravidians of Tamil Nadu in India. It is also spoken in other countries. The Tamil-speaking people across the world is above 10 crores. From this language all the other languages have developed. After a long generation gap, Abraham was called by God. Based on Abraham, the Jewish people came into existence, where they spoke Hebrew language as written in Genesis chapter 14 verse 13, and there came one that had escaped, and told Abram the Hebrew. Also you can see, the name of the Almighty Lord God is Yeshua in Hebrew. The same name is translated in Tamil as Yeshua. But in other languages they have changed the name to another name, which we have already published in the title Fabricated Name. But languages, race, tribes are not a matter for one to get into the kingdom of heaven. The real problem is sin, that is disobedience to God's law. With sin no one can enter into the kingdom of heaven. To wash away the sin from the sinful person, a sinless person has to give his life. The only sinless person is God himself. So, he himself came in the name Yeshua Messiah and gave his life on the cross, as written in John chapter 3 verse 16, "For God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." There is no other way to go to heaven except through him. So, if you want to go to heaven, you need to accept Lord God Yeshua Messiah as your God and Savior, leave out all your sinful activities, confess your sin to an apostle, get baptism in water and get spiritual baptism, meditate on his holy words, do and live as per his holy words in New Testament, the Gospel, walk with God, watch and wait for his holy call. Amen.